Hi, I'm Michal Chmielewski, and I am director of Roving Woman film. I'm very happy to be here, and it's our first time when the movie is showed to the audience outside domestic countries, which is US and Poland. So I'm very excited to see what people's reactions will be after the screening and the Q&A. It's our movie, The Roving Woman. It's real indie movie. It has this indie spirit, so this festival is perfect platform for this kind of movies. I'm super glad to be here. So the story started when I met Lena, the main actress in the movie, and we decided to write the script together. And we knew that it's gonna be a road movie, and we wanted to shoot it in Joshua Tree Desert in California because it was a metaphor of our characters' emotions and lives, emptiness, and it's a self-discovery movie. So it started when we met with Lena, and after the project grew up and we were able to hire like John Hawkes, Wim Wenders, Ariana Williams, like great professionals from the industry. Also, some of them are my idols, so I am honored to work with them, you know. So it's like real journey and adventure for me.
Starting with Wim Wenders, can you talk a little bit about what makes him such an iconic storyteller and what it was like to have him as a producing partner on this project?
So what I think what made him so unique and special is his style, the mood he can create in the movie, and I think he tells very personal stories. That's most important part. So he's very true, you know. He doesn't lie. Every movie of Wim Wenders I watched was like emotional and real, and he's also a good observer. And when he joined our crew, he was a kind of a partner for us, you know. He's master of the cinema, and for me it was like a really big thing to work with him. But he became our partner, so he was like we were consulting the editing, rough cuts with him, music, actually everything. So he became kind of my friend in this movie, in this project. It was quite a long process to have John in the movie because he's known that he's kind of like picky actor because he make perfect selections of the movies he's into. So we tried to convince him, sending him a script, but he wasn't like not sure about it. So I edited short teaser to show him the mood of the movie, and also there were a lot of there was Chris Hanley, famous producer, involved in the movie. So it was like the energy we gathered make people like wanted to join us, and John decided to join us finally, and we were very happy, and it was like, you know, big celebration for us. Our movie doesn't say like specific line what you have to think or see. It's more like it opens discussion. That's what I really like in the cinema, that people start talking. How you feel about being alone for the rest of your life? How you feel about being in a relationship for the rest of your life? You know, it's like more when Sarah meets characters. Everyone is different, and I wanted this movie to be, you know, like the open discussion for audience.
Can you talk about the unique production challenges and rewards of filming a road movie?
That's a good question. Actually, there are a lot of rewards because if you are with the crew following the character in the cars, sometimes you can see unpredictable situations happening around you, so you want it in the movie. And so, yeah, so we were open to shoot also in documentary style, also in hidden camera, to have some treasures we met on the road. And it's hard because you are always traveling and changing the location, but from the other side, it's a real journey also for the crew, so it makes like this movie special and unique. I think maybe the desert is the sound of loneliness. We tried to make this movie has parts which are very silent as well. So yeah, we wanted to leave a space also for not like make it very loud and it's not action movie. So we are trying to show like different emotions of the character by the sound also.
You're here tonight at a festival that above all, I guess, celebrates the power of storytelling. I know it's a big question, but what does it mean for you to be a storyteller and why does telling stories matter so much in all our lives?
You know, we tell the stories all the time to each other, so I think it's like the most common thing we do, and it's the way of sharing our thoughts and emotions. It's sometimes in a metaphorical way, so I think also like people on the street, they when they meet, they just share the stories. So I make the same, but using the pictures and sounds.
How vitally important do you think platforms like this festival are, particularly for independent cinema, for voices that perhaps would not be heard without it?
Yeah, it's very like hard times right now for indie cinema, generally for cinema, but I hope this platform helps us to find a distributor, and also we the press is really interested in our movie, so you know, it helps a lot to launch this movie, you know, to other people, and I hope Raindance also will help us to reach new audience.